Hello friends, welcome back to my channel View Tutorials. In this video we will discuss about Babcock and Wilcox water tube boiler. This is best known water tube of boilers and is made of one or more horizontal steam and water drums. The drum is connected to a series of front end and rear end headers by short riser tubes. A series of inclined water tube of solid round mild steel are connected to these headers. Each nest of tubes is made of several vertical rods. The tubes are expanded into headers which are provided with staggered or zigzag holes. Figure below illustrates the Babcock and Wilcox water tube boiler of the land type. The staggered arrangement of the water tubes will allow the surface of every tube to be exposed to the hot gases. A hand hole is provided in the header in front of each tube, which allow cleaning and inspection of tubes. Each hole is covered by a steel cap, which is secured in its position by a steel clamp. The hot gases from the furnace are forced to move upward between the water tubes by fire brick baffles provided. They then move downwards between the tubes and then to chimney or stack. The movement of gases in this manner facilitates the heat transfer even to the highest part of the tubes. The feed water enters the front of the drum, passes to the back of the drum, and then descends through the downcoming vertical tubes and enter the headers. The water then enters the water tubes, moves upward through the inclined tubes, and finally rises through the front riser tubes to the drum. The circulation of water is provided due to difference of density of water, which in turn is due to difference of temperature in the front and rear part of the furnace. Thus, a thermosiphon effect is created, which results in continuous and rapid circulation of water. The steam and water drum of the boiler is suspended from horizontal beams by means of metallic sling or straps. The horizontal beams in turn are support on cast iron columns. This arrangement makes the boiler unit independent of the brickwork, which eliminates troubles due to expansion. The brickwork around the boiler is only meant to enclose the furnace and the hot gases. A mud drum is provided at the lowest part of the inclined tubes. The sediment in water collects in the mud drum, from where it is blown off by means of a blow-off valve at regular intervals. The boiler is provided with the usual mountings as well as a superheater. The soot from the gases accumulating on the surface of the water tubes is removed at intervals either by mechanical scraper or it is blown off by high pressure steam blowers. This is necessary to keep the heat transfer by conduction effective. Straight tube and staggered header boilers will describe in detail in next video. So friends, if you like this video, then like and share. Also, don't forget to subscribe this channel and press bell icon for getting notification of my upcoming videos.